Who is the inner child? The inner child is a part of your mind. In some spiritual practice, it is also called a part of your soul. This part was developed during your childhood, in the past. Everyone has this part, no matter your gender, no matter your religion, belief system, or age. The inner child is part of us that is responsible for joy in our life, that is responsible for the ability to be spontaneous, to be creative, to have fun, to be easygoing, and to enjoy life itself. If you think about kids, they have the unique ability not to worry about tomorrow. They know how to have fun, how to be present, how to dream big. They know how to enjoy life and people around them. Children love to dream big. They say, when I grow up, I will buy a house. When I grow up, I will become a doctor. When I grow up, I will travel to the moon. When I grow up, I will be the president. They believe in themselves. They are not afraid of what other people will say or think about them. They have incredible imaginations and believe that everything is possible. What happens with our inner child when we grow up? When therapists, life coaches, spiritual mentors talk about the inner child, usually they say that you need to heal your inner child or you need to connect to your inner child. If you are struggling with creating a healthy, loving relationships in your life, if you have self-doubts, if you have low self-esteem and self-confidence, if you criticize yourself a lot, if you cannot achieve your dreams, then in most cases it means that your inner child has been hurt back in the childhood and still you feel this pain that is stopping you from achieving what you want in life. Basically, it means that when you were a child, you were affected by an event or several events. Usually, it's not one event, it's multiple events. And you could not process those events. Those events had a big impact on your psyche, even if you remember very little or nothing at all. A child does not understand why a traumatic event happened to him, but a child can feel the pain. A child has emotions and feelings, but he does not know what to do with them. Lots of adults don't know how to process their emotions. Lots of adults don't know how to deal with stressful situations. So if you think about a little child who is going through a traumatic event, often a child does not know what to do with those things that he or she feels inside. So we suppress those feelings, we suppress our pain for years. And when we grew up, we still have this pain, and this pain is stopping us from achieving our goals. Some people say that their childhood was not that bad. They had good memories and can even say that they were happy. Why might those people have problems with their relationships and careers? Most people have good and bad memories from their childhood. It's not about how bad or terrible your childhood was. It is more about how you deal with the negative events that do occur in your childhood. Siblings can react differently to their parents' divorce. Siblings can react differently to their grandparents' death. They can react differently to criticism. Some kids are more sensitive than others. Some kids receive more love and support than others. When a child cannot deal with a traumatic event, when they don't receive enough emotional support from adults, from their parents, or when they were traumatized or even abused by their caregivers, they create some type of a shield, a defense mechanism. And usually they create multiple defense mechanisms. And those mechanisms help them to suppress their feelings, their emotions, and ignore the pain. In order to do only one thing, these mechanisms work only for one goal, And this goal is to survive through this traumatic event.